Hello, welcome back. Welcome if you're new here. Today we're reacting to the opening for Vivy Fluorite's I song. I said that right. Right, yeah. Vivy Fluorite? It's Fluorite, I think. Vivy's Fluorite I song. This anime is not on my to watch list, honestly. I have heard good things about it, but honestly, I just have a lot of stuff that I'm watching right now, and I'm trying not to have too much on my watch list. But there was a couple people who wanted this, like me to react to this, so I figured why not. All I was able to find was the opening. I couldn't find the ending anywhere. Like I could find the ending song, but I couldn't find like the actual ending. So all I could find was the opening. So yeah. I haven't read the synopsis. But the synopsis says, an AI named Matsumoto appears before Vivy, the world's first autonomous humanoid AI. Matsumoto's mission to rewrite history together with Vivy in order to stop the war between AI and humans that will happen one century later. Okay, so I mean, it's not the most interesting thing I've read, honestly, but I have heard that that synopsis is very off-putting, I guess. It's a lot. I've heard it's a lot better than the synopsis actually says it is. So yeah, I don't plan on watching it, but. Yeah, I might in like the future, but like I'm not. So yeah, it's not on my to watch list, but because I'm watching like I know I said like after winter like 2021 I was not gonna be watching that many anime, but there was quite a few that catch my eye that I wasn't planning to watch like beforehand, like as it says Gridman and Megalobox. But I just finished SSS Gridman, and I'm up to date with Dinazanon too. I'm getting distracted. But like combined with all the anime I'm watching on my own, plus I'm reacting to Shadow's House, My Hero, and Attack on Titan, which I'm basically pumping out two episodes a week of that, Attack on Titan. I don't have a set schedule, but yeah, I don't have a lot else to say about this. I guess let's just start. I'm gonna turn on the display capture, and yes, let's just start. Okay, so let's just start in 3, 2, 1. The opening is called Sing My Pleasure. Was interesting. What was that? Ooh, I don't know if I like the art style. She looks like Rimuru. I'm guessing the teddy bears, the AI. Robots. The song's pretty good. It's way too loud, though. Oh, cool characters, though. Metronome. Oh, so she's just a schoolgirl. Oh, that was a cool shot, like a 360. There's not a lot of, I mean, I don't see that often, like in anime in general. Yeah, 'cause just time. She's trying to prevent something that happens later on. Ooh, that was a cool fight sequence, like a mini fight sequence that we saw there. Wonder what the thing is on her neck. Yeah, I don't like. This feel like that felt like something you'd see on like DeviantArt, honestly. I mean, it was a pretty good opening. I don't think it's like would be if I was watching it, I don't think it would be like on my favorites list of openings for that season. But like for some reason I just get like DeviantArt vibes from this. Yeah, like that fight sequence was really good. I will give them that. And also that pan around right here. Like, that takes skill to do, like, animation wise. It's like, congratulations to. I want to say Studio Wit is doing this, but I'm not sure. Yeah. Yeah, it is Studio Wit. Yeah. I mean, the main character looks pretty cool, but I'm not really sold on her, you know? The teddy bear AI looks cool too. But yeah, I mean, the song's really good too. I will give them that too. Yeah, like the song's actually pretty good. I'm surprised. I'm honestly surprised by that. Not in like a bad way, but I've had low expectations, honestly. But yeah, I mean the animation looks pretty good. A lot better than I thought it'd be. But yeah, I think that's kind of all I have for today. I guess I'll just see you guys next time, and bye.